Hello, people everywhere. I'm GM Grenna, and I'm getting ready to go to a stair climb training session. For the past 4 years or so, I've been using the Monster X-presso as a placebo to pump me up right before climb. And today's a special day because today is I have the final one. So this is the last one I'm going to drink because they stopped making them a couple years ago. And I, at that time, stocked up on, I bought cases of them. You can actually see a sample case here of the Monster X-presso. And there were two sizes that they made too. This is a small 6.75 ounce can. And this was the 9.8, is it? Yeah, 9.8 ounce can. And it got a whole bunch of delicious stuff in them. And I found that they were very useful for bumping me up an extra notch on my stair climb races and training sessions. So they were made in 2012. I have no idea why they stopped making them. This original one, they had hammer on the top, and maybe that was some kind of copyright problem. Because then this next version that came out, which is a slightly different mix of ingredients, which I'll pop up on the screen, they just called it Midnight. So I've now made my own concoction that is similar to it, but better. The only thing I really didn't like about this was it had sucralose in it. The other ingredients, you know, just the standard synthetic vitamins. I've already made a new version and used it at the past three stair climb races I've done with much success. So that's where I'm going to go now for the remainder of my races. And you can also see up here above me on my shelf, I kept some souvenir cans. These actually sell on eBay for about $1 each. And so I've got probably about three dozen or so cans up here that I'll keep as memorabilia and conversation pieces. So now I'm going to pop open my final can, and I wanted to make this video to preserve the memory. There we go, splattered it all over the place. And here it goes. So that should be about half the can. And take a breath. Ready for the final gulp. Didn't quite make it, so I got one more very small gulp to go. I think that's it. So now what I usually do is I fill it up with a little bit of water to make sure I get all of the coffee goodness out. Coffee energy goodness out. And then I'm off to my training session. Okay, so a couple weeks later, now I'm getting ready for another big, huge training session tomorrow. And so since I no longer have any more Monster X-pressos to get my caffeine for the extra boost as a mental placebo, I'm now switching over to a very natural source of caffeine from two types. One is from black tea, one is from green tea. And I found that this brand Yogi has some really cool herbs mixed in. There's probably about three dozen different ones of these different varieties. They have a whole bunch more varieties and flavors of tea, but these are the ones that contribute to energy because they have caffeine in them. So I used, because it's written in small print on the box, I wrote it with a big ink marker, the number of milligrams of caffeine in each of the different brands. You can see anywhere from 35 or 21 up to 80. And the different flavors here are basically anything with energy in the name: refreshing mint energy,
which is all black tea, no green. This one, Vanilla Spice Perfect Energy, is a combination of black tea and green tea. And it says this one energizes the body and focuses the mind. This other one had said that the black tea blend that naturally boosts energy, and green tea super antioxidant helps reduce free radicals. Green tea energy supports stamina, and green tea blueberry slim life energizes and supports a dieting program. So I've been experimenting with these for several months now to find the optimum amount. There's a recommendation from health agencies that you shouldn't have any more than 400 milligrams a day. And you don't really get any benefits after a certain amount either, like about 200 or so. And depending on the time, and also of course the amount of effort that you're, or the amount of physical activity that you're engaging in your body. So all of those things factor in. And so just to be sure I'm getting an optimal amount, but not too much, I'm going to be putting in six of these bags that add up to about 330 milligrams. So it's a totally safe amount. And I'm having three of the Vanilla Spice Perfect Energy, which has a combination of black and green, and then these other guys, which have a totally different mix of herbs, and they're all strictly green tea. So three of each. And then over here, I've already opened up the equivalent amount, six bags. There's all the tea bags. And these yogi guys, they got some interesting stuff on their boxes. Each box has some different information about in the back. It's very hard to read. I might pop some of it up here on the video about the health benefits of the different herbs that they mix into these things. But they also put on the bags little, I guess, yoga, Buddha, mental meditation kind of things. Labels. I've saved a whole bunch of them because I figured I'd make a video like this one day. So this is about 50 of them that are different ones. I put them in alphabetical order just to give you an idea of how kind of dumb some of these things are that, you know, is typical of yoga, non-Christian stuff. Recognize that the other person is you. That's like totally nonsensical. Recognize that you are the truth. Again, falsehood. There is one that I like though. So just for contrast, I wanted to show here. Use your head to live with heart. I thought that was kind of cute. So I like that. So I don't think all of them are stupid, but most of them are. And then so to sweeten this out, I'm going to be putting in this big former Gatorade bottle, 32 ounces. And I'm going to be putting in one pack of Kraft Pure Honey for each bag of tea that I have. I found that this just kind of works out to cancel out the bitterness of the herbs and other things that are in there. And these are 9 gram packs. And these are about half fructose and half glucose. And so I'm also gonna put in some sucrose, which is organic coconut sugar. And it's the difference between this, you know, your body breaks down sucrose into fructose and glucose. It has to do a little bit of work. Whereas here, the bees did the work. And they've already separated it into glucose and fructose. So another important thing, even like with Gatorade, they mix in different sugars so that your body can have different amounts available at different times during your exercise. So the only other thing I'm going to add is salt. I've got some sea salt here that has a bunch of minerals in it. So I'm going to add in 1 milliliter of salt and 15 milliliters of sucrose. That seems to be just about the right amount to do this. So the first thing I'm going to do is boil this water. I'm only filling up half the bottle of water because that'll be enough to mix all of these ingredients. No sense in wasting the microwave energy for that. So I'm going to pour that into, I guess I could microwave it in here if I knew it was safe, but this is a microwave safe container. This is about 1 pound of water, 16 ounces or so, somewhere between 16 and 19. And then this will get popped into my microwave to get boiling. Okay, so this is a two-hand operation, and I put in all the tea bags, wiggled them around a little bit, and now I'm gonna put a lid on that and just sit back here and wait for about, they recommend on the green tea to steep it for about 3 minutes, and for the black tea, 4 to 6 minutes. So I'm going to give it about 4 minutes here. Okay, so that 4 minutes is up, and now I'm going to just dump off all the little bit of extra water here from my lid and dip the bags a little bit, and also use a spoon to squish them a little bit as I pull them out and drain them. I'm gonna have to put the camera down because that's another two-hand operation. By the way, here's a close-up of the honey pack. I get these in boxes of 200, and they're cool to carry along. And so while this tea is usually steeping inside my container here, I'll put down the bags of packets of honey because I normally keep them in my refrigerator. I'm supposed to keep them in a cool, dry place. And I keep them, I have a box of 200 that I buy, and they're cold, so I bring them out here and put them on this nice warm thing so they'll soften up a little bit, make it easier to squeeze out and stir up and mix in to the tea and dissolve more evenly than if they were just cold, gooey lumps. Okay, so I just finished dumping in all 6 packs of my honey. Gonna just stir that around a little bit and make sure that's mixed up really nice. And then I'm going to stick in my 1 milliliter of sea salt, roughly. Dump that in. Then this is going to be another two-hand operation to get the 15 milliliters of sugar out of here. Okay, so there it is. I'm dumping that in. And then I'll stir that up. So this is my Monster Espresso substitute. It is all natural, lots of herbs, and in fact, I'm going to read off some of the highlights on these Yogi boxes of what the different herbs, some of them, contribute to the energy and energizing factor. So I'm going to put this in here. It's all stirred up and mixed up and dissolved while it's warm, and then I'm gonna stick it in my refrigerator before I pour it into my old Gatorade bottle, and then I'll fill up the bottle with water to make the most of this concoction. So, by the way, I didn't have any of these refreshing mint vital energy that is all black tea. I happened to run out of the bag, and I just didn't buy a new one to replenish it yet. But on the back of this one, so the organic Assam black tea and green tea extract deliver an invigorating burst of energy, while organic peppermint leaf, kola nut, and guarana seed support natural energy flow. Ginger and cinnamon bark complement the spirited peppermint to gently warm and detoxify. Cup after cup, this deliciously invigorating tea can help you feel fully vitalized so you can perform at your best. With a little asterisk saying none of these statements have been evaluated by the FDA. Product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease, blah, blah, blah. Okay, and now this one is the green tea super antioxidant. And what it does, what it has, our special formulation of organic green tea along with grapeseed and amla extracts supplies naturally potent antioxidants which help to reduce free radicals. Organic lemongrass adds bright citrus flavor, while licorice and jasmine green tea lend sweet and floral notes. So relax and rejuvenate with a cup of green tea super antioxidant. Then the green tea blueberry slim life. It claims that we add organic green tea and Garcinia cambogia fruit extract in combination with ginseng and Eleuthero extracts to support stamina. Light and sweet blueberry flavor and hints of organic hibiscus make green tea blueberry slim life a fragrant and delicious addition to a weight loss program of exercise and a balanced diet. And green tea energy. Blending herbs that can help promote greater energy and well-being, our special formula contains smooth organic green tea that supplies antioxidants which can help protect the cells in the body. We then add Eleuthero root along with Panax ginseng root, herbs traditionally used to support stamina. Lemongrass and spearmint impart crisp, refreshing flavor and round out this harmonious blend. Enjoy this invigorating and full-flavored green tea throughout the day to support your energy and well-being. And then last but not least, the Vanilla Spice Perfect Energy. Looking for a perfect energy boost? Discover Yogi Perfect Energy, a unique blend of tea with naturally invigorating herbs that energize the body and focus the mind. A complex and delicious blend of organic green tea and organic Assam black tea combine with natural amino acid L-theanine to invigorate the body and promote mental focus. Traditionally used, here's a tough one, Ayurvedic herbs, organic go-to kola leaf, and ashwagandha help support clarity. You probably need that just to be able to pronounce this sentence. Vanilla bean and exotic spices combined for a delicious and intriguing tea that is sure to energize the body while calming and focusing the mind with every cup.